know that we have but one, and she's not supposed to be a child anymore, but if you would, go around and collect the dollars and come on up. And Ruth is going to have the children's story.
I think there's a basket somewhere. You don't have to touch it.
I tell you, anyone that feels like a child can go around and collect money too. For the summer. That was a little bit
harder because it was more than just 2 weeks. It was 2 months. When Sabbath came, Cecil would take a little handful of food and he would go off. He would take his Bible and go off to his little private worship place. The second Sabbath that he was home for summer vacation, he had a surprise when he got to his private worship place because his dad was there. And his dad wasn't particularly happy. He stood there with his arms crossed and said, "No, not today. You need to go take care of the sheep." And Cecil said, "Father, I cannot." Dad promptly disciplined his son the way he thought was best. He beat him so badly that he could not sit down. And took him home, and he was confined, he was grounded. The next Sabbath, the same thing happened. The third Sabbath, the father said, "Why do you do this? Why do you defy your elders?" Cecil had to explain to him that, "I'm not defying you. I am obeying God. I'm obeying the Great Spirit." Dad was very upset. "Is that what you learn at that school? You are never going back to that school. You have got to learn." And he endured another beating. Cecil didn't give up, though. Even though he suffered a broken arm and a broken nose, when it came time to go back to school, Mom and Grandma had convinced Dad it would be best, because Cecil was causing a lot of trouble at home. He needed to go back to that school and get out of the house, be away, so that he wouldn't cause any more trouble. Well, as Cecil's family was bringing him back to school, the father went and talked to the principal. "I do not approve of the way you teach my child. You are teaching them to disobey, to be disrespectful, and to ignore our ways." The principal was very, very patient and sat down with the father and talked with him and showed him from the Bible where God has given us instructions to keep the Sabbath holy and to honor our parents. And Dad asked him, "Other than on Saturday, does Cecil talk back to you?" And Dad stopped and thought and said, "Not anymore." "Does Cecil do his chores to the best of his ability?" "Well, Cecil does his chores best of all my children." Principal said, "Does Cecil lie, cheat, steal?" "Not anymore." Dad started thinking. They left Cecil. The principal gave his father a Bible, and he took the Bible back with him. At first he was disgusted, and he threw the Bible in the corner. Well, one day, the hogan got infested with little creepy things. The ones with the stingers on the end, scorpions. Somehow the scorpions had gotten in, and they had to clean the house out. They found the scorpion nest, they cleaned it out, but that scorpion nest happened to be right next to the Bible that was in the corner. So they cleaned everything out, and Mother saw this Bible, and she looked at it. Father and said, "And why is this book here?"
"Well, Cecil's principal gave it to me, and I didn't want to insult him, so I took it."
And Mother said, "Well, did you read it?"
"Why should I read it?"
"Because it's about the Great Spirit." So Father sat down and he read it. Not only did he just read it a little bit, he started at the beginning, and it was hard at first, but the more time he spent reading the Bible, the more he the more peace he felt in his heart. So when he got to go back to school to pick up Cecil, he talked with the principal and asked the principal to baptize him, because what they were teaching his son is what he wanted. He wanted to have the peace. He wanted to have a personal relationship with the Great Spirit, with God. So many times we think that the little things that we do don't matter. It doesn't matter if I lose my temper because, you know, nobody's going to pay attention. It doesn't matter if I don't follow through with what I've said I'm going to do, because who cares? God cares. And whatever we do, wherever we are a witness for God. Would you like to have prayer?
Dear God, please help us to always